Are you trying to decide between iMovie and Final Cut Pro? Well, this video will clearly give you all the advantages and disadvantages of both programs, including a free comparison sheet for you to download. My name's Bruce, and if we've met before, welcome back. Otherwise, please like and subscribe and press the bell so I can make more videos like this for you. And to celebrate, I'm offering the first 200 students who download my free video editing tips. It's a $30 off for my one-on-one training courses. iMovie has major real-life advantages, and these are in its simplicity for beginners. When you look at the disadvantages of iMovie, they imply the reasons why you need Final Cut Pro. I'll cover the advantages of iMovie first. The most obvious is that iMovie is free, and it's included with every new Mac. It's very simple to use, requires no prior knowledge of editing software, nor any previous video editing skills. In fact, it's 99% of what you need to get started. Add to that, it's very fast and smooth on virtually all Macs, old and new. All in all, it's the best place to start learning to edit. One of the biggest differences between iMovie and Final Cut Pro is that iMovie works on both iPhone and iPad, albeit a little differently than on a Mac. But iPhone and iPad edits can be transferred to a Mac for that final edit. This means that you can start editing in the field on your iPhone or your iPad, and then be well on the way to completing with the bigger screen and the more featured Mac version. It's a common myth that iMovie can't edit 4K. Well, that's completely untrue. To edit 4K, you just need to start your timeline with a 4K clip. There's a tutorial linked in the description below to change iMovie project videos' resolutions. Another myth is that iMovie can't do meaningful color correction. Again, that's untrue. You can adjust color substantially by using the iMovie toolbar. Check the video linked in the description below, iMovie toolbar. iMovie can also stabilize shaky video, and there's a video for that in the description below. And finally, iMovie's got some really cool features like Ken Burns effects and the ability to do green screen editing. So that covers the advantages of iMovie. What about the disadvantages? As I said before, if any of these are important to you, then you need to think about getting Final Cut Pro. The first, in my mind, the biggest disadvantage of iMovie is the lack of audio meters. Sure, you can adjust the audio level on your computer speakers, but to be absolutely clear, that will not affect the volume of the exported video. It could be too loud or too soft. Of course, you can adjust the audio in the timeline, but your only measure is how it sounds on your computer, not how it'll be exported. What you do have, though, with iMovie is that you can see the color of the audio waveforms, green, orange, and red. The red indicates too loud, but there's nothing to show what's too low. And too low would mean that anyone viewing your video would not be able to hear any sound at all. So my suggestion is to make sure that the audio in the timeline has orange at the peaks, but never red at the peaks. Then you'll have a good chance of a reasonable audio level, but not as certain as if you had audio meters. And while talking about audio, here's another myth that audio in iMovie can only be adjusted at one volume level per clip. Again, that's untrue. If you want to adjust audio within a clip, use the range tool to adjust just that portion of the clip. There's a link in the description to a video about the range feature, and it's called Secret Range Selection Tool. iMovie is also limited to one aspect ratio. That's 16 by 9, which is the shape of a TV screen. And that means you can't have square or vertical sizes for social media, like Instagram or TikTok, Facebook or Twitter. As you get to work with iMovie, you'll find that the titles are not just limited, but they're also very restrictive. They mainly only appear in one place on the screen and can't be moved around. And you'll start to notice that you've only got the titles and effects that are supplied with iMovie. You can't buy any third-party extras. The supplied titles and effects will be enough to start with, but you'll eventually want more variety and flexibility, at least to position words anywhere on the screen. iMovie is limited to one video track and one cutaway track. Multiple tracks of video would allow you to show multiple panels of video like this. The limit on tracks also means that you'll not be able to match a second camera to be able to cut between them in a multicam edit. You can't even do it manually because of just having one track available. And this means if you've recorded with several cameras and you want to match those up, you'll need Final Cut Pro's automatic way of syncing those multiple cameras, and it's called multicam. Check the tutorial linked in the description. Easy multicam editing Final Cut Pro. Fine rotation is another major disadvantage of iMovie. iMovie can only rotate in 90 degree amounts. So if your horizon is not level, well, you're out of luck. And this is how Final Cut Pro rotates to any angle. But there is a workaround for iMovie that involves exporting and rotating in Apple's Keynote. And there is a tutorial. And again, it's in the description below. So if you're finding these iMovie disadvantages insurmountable, there's really good news. You can transfer individual projects or all of your projects to Final Cut Pro so that you can immediately start editing them with the features that you're missing in iMovie. And there are two tutorials showing you how to do that, again, in the description below. The best news when you transfer to Final Cut is that things work in the same manner. And even the keyboard shortcuts that you've learned in iMovie are the same in Final Cut Pro. And the links in the description allow you to download the Final Cut Pro shortcuts. It's easy for you to try out Final Cut Pro. Apple is offering a 90-day free trial. And again, the link is in the description. Now let's look at Final Cut Pro. The major disadvantages of Final Cut Pro for beginners is the increase in options and menus. While being much more capable, it means that Final Cut is much more complex. It'll take you time to learn all those extra features that you didn't have in iMovie. Final Cut has got vastly more detailed color correction and audio correction, but as I mentioned before, because of the detail, it's a big learning curve. The audio features can do things like reducing the background noise, as well as improving vocals. And that's really useful for YouTubers. Look at all these Logic Pro features for improving audio. As I said, there's a learning curve, but don't worry, I'm here to help. I've got online modules like Pick My Brain, where you can ask questions about issues that you're having problems with. And there's a module for more advanced learners, Upscale Final Cut Pro. And finally, a module for those wanting ongoing support on a monthly membership module that you can join for as little as 1 month at a time. And remember just one thing about Final Cut Pro. Just because it can do a lot, you need to know how to use it. If you've enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe and press the bell. And don't forget to download my 10 video editing tips for that $30 discount. Thanks for watching.